Just make something. Bible says in the last day, something will happen to the world. The first thing that will happen is that the mountain of the house of the Lord will be established. It will be exalted above every mountain. Do you know that, prophetically speaking, there are many kinds of mountains in the world. There's mountain of media, mountain of finance, mountain of religion. There are different kinds of mountains. Mountain simply means different areas of human works. They now say something that for the Lord's house will be exalted above every other mountain. It will be so exalted that the people will look and say, Kai, let us go to church. Let us go to those people. Let them teach us their ways. It's just like, let me give you a simple example. You are in the ministry. You work in, let's say, ministry of works. Your life should be able to shine to the point that you are not carried by Bible to go and preach. They are the ones coming to you and say, please, teach us something about God. It's not you going to preach, because there are two dimensions of the gospel. There's one that will take the gospel to the world. There's one that the world comes to the gospel. Hallelujah. So what God does is that we beautify God. We advertise God. We reflect God, His life, so much that people begin to see it. Hallelujah. Let me give this simple example. There's a lady called Mercy Chimo. She sang a song. And then Davido did a post and said that Mercy Chimo's song has been a blessing to him, right? That it uplifts his spirit. And then people were like, really? No. But you know, the words of Mercy Chimo are not new words. People have been singing them in their own songs. But there was a way she packaged them and presented it to the world. That even a secular artist, people who don't love, who don't seem to proclaim Jesus, can love them and say, please, he hears her song every morning. Hallelujah. That means that this is one of God's biggest strategy. That He built the church here, puts the world here. And the excellency of the church will override the excellency of the world. But do you know that, ma'am, the church runs to the world to copy from them. Instead of the world copying, that is what is happening right now. Any new song in the world, any new pattern, we bring them to the church. And it's time for us to start exporting the virtues of Christ to the world so that they can run and come and say, please, we've noticed you people that you guys have been married and no divorce. There's high rate of divorce, but we notice that in this church, all of them that are married after 20 years, they still remain married. 30 years have passed, they are not us. Please teach us, what are you people teaching? How come? So the world is expected to learn from the church. Now, the church begins to shoot movies. We have Mount Zion, hallelujah. We package it in so much excellence and release it to the world. And they look at it. It's both entertaining and educating. Yet, there's no loop inside. There's no violence so much inside that one can learn and become evil. And they say, you guys are doing the same thing you are doing. Yes, you are not involved in iniquity. How are you guys doing these things? So they can come. Hallelujah. Amen. But unfortunately, we conform more than we. Hallelujah.
Amen.
I'll wrap it now so we can just pray.